My name is Anna Radke, and I am a postdoctoral fellow in the Laboratory of Behavioral and Genomic Neuroscience, which is in the National Institutes on Alcohol Abuse and Alcoholism. So our lab is interested in how alcohol affects the brain, but it certainly is something that touches a lot of us and really is one of the major health crises in the United States and in the world. I grew up in Cary, Illinois, which is outside of Chicago. I had a really great upbringing, just, you know, typical suburban life. I remember I did the science fair in seventh grade and got to go downstate and present a poster and do a project. So I think that was one of the earliest times that I really started to think, oh, science is something that I could keep doing and that I'm good at and really like to do. My mom's interested in medicine and science. She's in the medical field, and she always would bring home scientific articles, and I'd read about scientists doing their work, and instilled in me just a sense of exploration. And that always seemed really interesting to me, that you could wake up every day and go to work and ask questions about how the world works and then try to figure out what the answers to those questions are. So in the short term, we're looking for specific changes in brain function that could be related to alcohol exposure. Okay. What brain region are you looking at?
I'm looking at the amygdala right now, and like kind of the prefrontal cortex.
Yeah, show me some of your pipetting. Let's see it in action.
Definitely. So basically you just have to make a lot of different chemical reactions to get the tissue to stay in the way that you need it to.
Yeah, I saw what you were working at, some of the ones you did. I saw them on the microscope. They look really good. So
yeah.
I think that you've perfected this technique, and it's looking really good.
Yeah, I've been working on it.
You know, you've designed this whole experiment. You've put in a lot of work, and then you have the data, and you get to analyze it, and you get kind of nervous, like, oh, is it going to work out, or what actually happened here? And it's really exciting to see that result and realize that you discovered something new.
Okay,
so this is what we've been looking at with the NR1 virus, right?
Yeah.
And we saw how often they were pressing during the available session versus the unavailable session. But we don't see any differences between the two genotypes yet. Working with other scientists is really fun and really engaging. I mean, we have a great group of people in our lab, and we all get along and love to work together, and we're always, you know, coming up to each other and saying, hey, I had an idea for a project, could you help me with this? It just makes for just a really engaging atmosphere to work in. We do other procedures to sort of manipulate brain function. One of the paradigms we have is what's called punished reward seeking, and this really is meant to model the fact that alcoholics and people who are addicted to other drugs of abuse will continue to be compelled to take their drug even though it might be ruining their life. They're looking at that on the microscope, looking for different patterns of expression and that sort of thing.
DAPI stains the cell bodies of neurons, so it stains the DNA and the nucleus. This gives us an idea of where we are in the brain.
So it was injected in hippocampus?
Yes.
Back over a number of years, the goal would be for preclinical research like this to translate into therapies for people who actually suffer from alcohol use disorders and substance abuse. My advice would be to just try it out. There are so many opportunities, even from a very young age, that you can get involved in a lab. People love to show you what they know, so don't be afraid to just contact people, try to get exposure to it, and you might discover, hey, I really love this and it's something I want to keep doing.